What a great day to be alive, guys. My name is Edward John, and you are watching Fearless Living. The Bible says, "This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." You see, a lot of us aren't glad. God wants you to be happy. He wants your cup to be full of joy, full of gladness, full of vision, and full of purpose. So I chose this set of Life Today television today to illustrate to you a very powerful point. You see, James and Betty Robinson are the hosts of this television show that reaches millions of people across the earth. And they, on a daily basis, share about the love of Jesus and the purposes that he has and the plans that he has for everybody. But not everybody gets it because they're struggling with the fear of God. God wants you to succeed. He wants you to reach your destiny. And he wants you to become all that you're meant to be. Today, we're going to be talking about the fear of God and how we can together understand the principle of abiding under his shadow. But before I get into my teaching, why don't you listen to the first verse of my favorite song, "I Worship You."
My door is closed, my eyes are shut. I'm on my knees and my hands are up. Tears running down my face, I turn to you. My heart is weak, I can hardly speak. All my strength is gone, I'm all alone. I open up my heart to you and worship you.
Maybe your heart is weak and you can hardly speak. Maybe you feel all alone and you don't know where to go. God is there for you. Don't think that you are not worthy enough or good enough. See, that's what keeps people away from God. But listen to me carefully. The Bible says if we will draw near to God, then God will draw near unto us. And if you are the way that I used to be, you probably think, well, how can I draw near to God after all the things that I have done wrong in my life? Well, wrong. It's wrong not to draw near to God because he created you for his pleasure. You are made to please God. So in other words, God has made you and me so that we can fellowship with him. And if we don't fellowship with God, we're actually making him sad. He wants us to bring our troubles, our burdens, our thoughts, our heartaches, everything we are, bring it to him. He wants to be a part of it. He wants you and I to know that we are surrounded by his help. What do you mean, Eddie, surrounded by his help? What I mean is this. God said, I am for you. I'm not against you. I'm going to make a way for you where there is no way. He says, what man can't do for you, I can do for you. He says, all things are possible for those who believe. But the fear of God holds us back because we don't feel worthy enough to be able to step into that shadow that God has made for us to dwell in. And I want to share with you today that if you take a step toward the shadow of the Almighty. You see, the thing that makes us afraid is, number one, we think we can't keep the laws and the boundaries that God has set for us because we feel we don't have the strength to do so. So instead of running to him, we run away from him. And we say, I don't want anything to do with that. But what God wants us to do is to run close into him so that he can give us the strength to overcome the things that so easily seem to entangle themselves in our lives. Don't let the fear of God stop you from entering into his presence. I'm going to share a secret with you in just a few seconds, but before I do so, listen to another part of my song. This is the second verse. Listen carefully and let it minister to you, and I'll come back and share a very powerful secret with you about how one day can be better for you than 1,000 days somewhere else.
Time seems gone. I'm on promises will be fulfilled in me. All I do is believe in you. I trust in you and know that it's true. And all that I have hoped for, it will come true. And I...
Maybe you feel like time is gone. You're getting older. You feel like you've missed out because you haven't ran in under God's protection yet with your life. But let me encourage you. There's a king in the Bible. His name is King David. It's the only man in the Bible that God talked about and said, that is a man after my own heart. God loved David. David made a lot of mistakes, though. He was not a perfect man, but he had a perfect heart. Because he knew that no matter what he had done, no matter where he came from, no matter what it looked like, he could still come back to God, his Father. And you see, it's the fear, the wrong fear of God, that keeps us away from the love and protection of God. So you might be out there and you're thinking, I'm not worthy. I'm not good enough. But God looks at you and he says, son, come home. Daughter, come back. I want to fellowship with you. I want to dine with you. Tell me all the things that you go through. Tell me about your problems. Share them with me. Share with me your ups and your downs, your victories and your defeats. I want to be a part of your life. And I want to be your father. I want to be your friend. You know, one of the greatest things I think in the Bible is when Jesus said, I no longer call you servants, I call you my friend. When I talk to my friends, I'm not afraid to share with them my ups and my downs because I know they'll understand. And God understands even more than my friends. So why should I be worried about telling him about my mistakes? You see, what we should be afraid of, though, is running too far away from him. From the age of 7, I used to be a ski jumper back in my home country, Norway, which ski jumping was our national sport. And, you know, from the time when you're 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 years old, ski jumping's okay. It's not all that scary. But by when you hit the age of 12, 13 and 14, you're looking at Olympic-sized ski jumps. And no matter how good you were at ski jumping, it scared you. But you know, my mom always told me, and I remember this like it was yesterday. She said, I remember I was walking out with my helmet under my arm and skis on top of my shoulders and the boots in my bag going to the ski slope. And my mom said, Eddie, remember to say every time you do a ski jump, dear Lord Jesus, be with me. And I never forget it because every time I got scared and I was sitting on the beam about to jump and go 65 miles an hour down the slope and fly through the air and I felt fear come on me, I would just whisper this prayer beneath my breath and it was, dear Lord Jesus, be with me. And every time I prayed that, fear disappeared from me and somehow I got through it and I became one of the top ski jumpers in my nation for my age group as a junior. And I believe that it was the prayer of, dear Lord Jesus, be with me, that made me overcome the fear factors in my life and made me a good ski jumper. And whatever you're facing in life, it might be business, it might be drawing near to God, it might be marriage that's coming up, it might be you just doing sports like me, but if you just simply say, dear Lord Jesus, be with me, you have the healthy fear of God. We should do with everything in us, we should draw close to the living God. Because in that shadow of protection, we're going to find life.